We've got some in the town there.
I just got that one off from him.
Thank you very much.
Good evening, welcome everybody. It's such a warm summer's evening that we've all turned out to ensure democracy flourishes at our small corner of the world, eh? So, as usual, can we start with apologies for absence?
John McGrath apologised, it's some personal stuff come up, so he needs that to.
Sorry,
Alex. Oh, my apologies.
Okay, we've got apologies from Councillor Britton. Councillor Brown?
No.
I'm sorry, I didn't realise since we signed it. Councillor Ensor. Councillor S. Ensor. And Jamie Brown. We also had a phone message from a female person, but couldn't hear the name on it, so I'm not quite sure.
It's for the Joe, I don't know.
Because the town clerk is new, we usually read out some declarations of interest in group order. But can you just declare what interests you have now, please, and then the visitor can get a head round who's got what interests on and what is serving on. So, for example, if you're on borough,
excuse me, can I just ask if anybody wants to speak, if they could just raise their hand and then say the name, because I don't know everybody's name. That would be very helpful, Jeremy.
We'll get your names. Of course, the town clerk's new, she won't have everybody's names. Just say your name when you're here.
So, we're not declaring it, or do we?
You declare interest. Yeah. Any interest? Push your hands up, declare it.
Yeah.
Or go around and take it to you.
Name.
Name.
Amanda Ball.
Allotments.
There's caps up,
Jason,
no. I've got nothing at the minute. Mm-hmm. I might mention something of mine.
We've got a ton of
Brian or Eric, whatever you want to call
them. Allotments,
yeah.
Is it a bit of a chance? What's that?
Richard, Roxburgh Council. I think that puts planning as well, isn't it? Mm-hmm. I think that's it.
Chris Rice, Roxburgh Council.
Thank you. Roxburgh Council.
John Ball, Roxburgh Borough Council, and I'm also an allotment holder.
Council of Roxburgh County.
Mm-hmm. Roxburgh and Council.
Do you want to learn anything?
Council Dorby, and it's Roxburgh Borough Council, and the Long Tom.
Council David Winnell.
Okay.
So we've got two sets of meeting notes to look at, so obviously those people have attended the ones. So those held on the 6th of April, like a proposer and a seconder. First of all, a proposer.
So, Councillor Greenberg's proposer and Councillor McGregor's the seconder.
That's on the 6th of April.
Seconder
was Councillor McGregor.
Second. And that was the 6th of April.
And that was the 6th of April. Then on the 18th of May, so Carol will have, well, let's have two different people. So Councillor Rice or proposer.
Was that the 15th of May?
That was on the 18th of May. Just to make sure that any objections or clarifications on those for those two meetings will be. Mayor's engagements. So Martha, please. Request by the members of the public to address the town council.
No, haven't received any.
So on to Mayor's engagements. The only event I've attended was the allotment group. I've never attended in 4 years, which was to my and my bad, but I enjoyed the enthusiasm that was coming over from allotment holders and the team. It was good to see. So I thank Deputy Mayor Brian Hull for attending the Hemlock Avenue on the 9th of June. I'd love to have gone to that. My wife's birthday, so I had something arranged, and it was a little bit as a week's notice on that. And just to thank him in advance, the thing I really wanted to attend was the Armed Forces Day, being an ex-member of the Armed Forces, but I'm on holiday for that. So thank you very much for that. Now, on this Armed Forces Day, there's a request for raffle prizes. So all those Christmas presents you've got gathering dust, like fancy biscuits, chocolate, in date, please, wine, luxury bits and pieces like the soaps you think you'll never use. That'll be very good for raffle prizes. Poppy prom, we're mentioning this in each week, but it is fast approaching. Tickets are available. It looks like a good event. I'm certainly going. And also we have dates for the garden competition.
The closing date for the garden competition is the 3rd of July. And please include in where it ends as well.
As for the report.
So
what's the report from the garden? So next agenda on the item is a section 137 request, and it's a good application to consider funding under this heading. So if you haven't read it already, I'll take a moment to read that. Before any discussion, of course, Town Clerk, any comments that you have on
that? Can I just say there is a copy of the application that Pegs is building. If anyone wants to see it, they can do. Can I also advise you that Pegasus received £200 in December 2017 for equipment, and although it's unusual to award further funding so soon, I just want to stress that the exceptional circumstances regarding the personal defibrillator, because it's not just for the club, it is also for the general community, and one of the big factors is the outstanding position of the park. So, if there's any comments, that's...
I was going to say that they were awarded something in December. My only other little bit that's reading that, does the unit will be kept in the team's clubhouse?
No, it won't be.
No,
well, that's what it says here.
Right, okay.
That would concern me because they're not open to the general public.
Yes, on the outside.
Can I just say that Margaret has spoken to them and they have clarified since this is done. It's going to be on the outside of the building. Okay?
Councillor Craig, next. Yeah, I mean, details, probably through, it's quite a lot of the place. It did upset me a bit, people saying in the paper and or even in the agenda that it's isolated and that, because it isn't. It's one on Warbridge Lane and it does cover a big area. I printed some maps out, but details are brilliant. You know, we've got one on, there's one in, I forget what it's called now, Stoke Town Football Club, we've got one in there. even though he's obviously in the area. So, you know, like if you've got your kids when they're playing football and they're running around and that, it's closer than being down in the street, isn't it? And I did read something the other day saying that they've raised about £700, which I think is brilliant. And with this being about £1,000, I'd like to propose that we give them £300 towards it to make up the money. And I was going to say, as long as it's in the cabinet outside, because it needs to be, but from listening to what you're saying, it seems it does. If someone was setting that, I think that's what I'd like to say anyway. I think it makes money for them.
Councillor Riddle was for the
You want to pay
£300? I'm quite happy to see them receive a £300. I would second Councillor Richmond Ray's. And I think it's only good for the community, so yeah, £300.
I'd say thank you very much, Richard, for proposing that's very kind of you. I'd say, as we all know, Margaret was to her cost, obviously, but how important these are. So, once again, thank you for everybody. So it's great that we all support these sort of things.
If anyone sees them, tell them, because they've done their ball raising £700 in a day. It's a lot of money, yeah. So, you know, they've raised a lot, haven't they? So, you know, if we can do a little bit to help them, why shouldn't we?
From a medical perspective, you have 3 minutes to apply this shock, and that's assuming that CPR is good while you apply it. So, I'm not going to tell you.
Like I say, they've had a few problems with their chairperson. They'd only had a couple of days to actually take over, so from what they raised in one day, it is fantastic, really. So, all good to them. So, thank you very much.
Can I just say that Councillor John Longdon? Is also donating £350 towards it from his divisional fund. And there's been obviously some private donations, so with that.
From a council perspective, yeah. Though, you've got to be thankful for that.
So, shall we just say a big thank you to John and everybody who has sort of helped him?
Right,
Okay, so the proposal from Richard then. Can all those that are in favour please raise their arm?
Neighbourhood planning.
Can I just say I wasn't actually involved in this because I'm new, but Margaret's done a lot of work, and if you don't mind, I'll get Margaret to report.
There is a CAB bit on the whole section 137.
Oh, my apologies. Thank you.
That's only for noticing.
That's not part of the one before.
Yeah, sorry. The CAB bit, yeah. It's only for noting. Okay. Just for information then, guys. Okay. Right,
so back to
legal
planning.
Have
you got any objections?
Sorry, it actually says the meeting is asked to note report, agree not to award funding to request, and it's got four different things on there to do. It doesn't say it's a noting report, you look at the conclusion.
Adjourn for 5 minutes.
Well, adjourn for 5 minutes and then we'll get an explanation.
Right. What you've got in front of you, Mr. Chairman, if I can just bring it up again. The report is dealing with funding for Peggy for Youth Fund for Youth Football Club. You're asked to note the report, which you've done so. Agree not to award funding as requested. You've agreed to award funding. So you've resolved to request that funding, okay?
Okay.
It's just a matter of course. You've agreed towards the funding, that's it. You've got the information to tell you that you had considered giving one to CAV and Health Review before. It's just for your information so that when you're reading the report you understand that this is about Pegasus. You previously looked at giving funding under CAB and under Helpful Bureau, but as a number of people were not necessarily at the previous meeting, they had to be aware that it wasn't going to be funded under Section 137.
You just didn't make that very clear on the agenda, that's all. It makes sense, but you didn't make it very clear. Mark, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Neighbourhood planning now. As I was just saying, I've not been involved in it, but if there's any objections, Margaret will happily report on it. So, any objections if Margaret reports on this? No?
Thank you very much. I've got a good answer. Neighbourhood planning, right. We're at the point where we're almost ready to go out to the next layer of consultation. I hope to get it out to everyone, but I only received some of the information from the planning consultant this afternoon. I haven't even looked at it yet, because it didn't come in until late today. That's why I haven't sent the thing out, it's incomplete. However, I happened to be in Roxburgh Council last week and was speaking to the Chief Executive and to Stephen Saunders, the planning department, and both of whom have suggested that if you would like to send them the copy of the document that you intend to send out for consultation for Stefan to have a look at before it goes to consultation, and they will give you any comments back, and that this will help you to make amendments before you send it to consultation, that hopefully it would go out and you wouldn't have to then go out, come back, go out again. This is an offer that's made to you free if you would like Roxburgh Council to have a look at it. You need to make that decision, not me.
Thank you, Margaret.
You've got
so we're going to go down to the seat, I'll just see if there's anything else to say. So, Councillor Holford.
Right. Like I say, I haven't had much to do with it, obviously, Dave and Richard has, but I haven't had to do with what I haven't done. So, the ladies have mentioned it to me, so I said that it might be better if Stephen's offering to look at it free, shall we say, you know, to me, give his advice. Why not send it to him first? Let him look at it, because the moment he said it wouldn't pass. So surely it would be better to send it to him, let him look at it, send us any notes back, then he can come back to the committee, you all then to make those notes to Ken, Ken to do the changes, and then send it out to everybody. But that's what I think the best, but obviously, I'd say you've been on the committee, so you'll know better than me.
Councillor
Craig. Yeah, I'm a little bit wary of that. I'm not saying don't do it, it's up to everyone. I'm a bit wary, and the reason being, there was a meeting at Roxburgh, and I can't remember what meeting it was, but I remember that set. And someone mentioned the state of the neighbourhood plan, and Stephen said, oh, it's not this, that, and the other, and he said he's working with us to make it as it should be. Well, it hasn't been working with us, it hasn't turned to any meetings. And as far as I'm aware, I don't think he's even replied to any emails, so I'd be a bit wary, because this is our neighbourhood plan, it's a state of the neighbourhood plan. And a lot of people, more so residents, is it trees that work very hard, and you know, we've got to be very grateful to these people, otherwise we still be twiddling our thumbs. And it's our neighbourhood plan, it's not Broxtow's neighbourhood plan. And ours doesn't have to fit in with the Broxtow one, ours is what ours is. And if they don't like it, this is me as a town councillor, kind of tough luck, because this is ours, we do it what we want, not for them to come and tell us how we should do it. But, like I said, you know, it's nice to get the advice off you. It doesn't mean you've got to listen to what he recommends, does it?
Obviously, like I say, you've dealt with it, but, like I said, you don't have to take his advice under consideration, but surely, even if you just send it to him, for his notice to, I thought his expertise in that sort of thing would be better, and he could then come back to you. If you then didn't want to take those on board, surely then that is the time to say, right, okay, well, we'll take them on board, or no, we won't, we'll carry on, we'll send it out. The concern I have is that if it goes out as it is now for everybody, then it's going to come back again, then you've got to rechange it, send it back out, and then if they send it back out again, that's all I'm concerned about. It's never ever going to get finished this way. That's all I'm...
Yeah. Well, I'm not saying don't do it, I'm just concerned that it,
but
that's all.
Well, I mean, obviously we'll vote on it, but it's, I'm taking advice from everybody, you lot should no better than these sort of things, you've dealt with it, but so that's how I feel, but obviously.
You just said he's already said it won't pass. Why won't it pass?
I don't think Margaret, sorry.
When I spoke with them, he said it was deep, and as it stands at the moment, it wouldn't pass the rules.
But if he hasn't seen it, how does he know?
Because he's seen the original document.
Right, okay.
I think we should heed Broxdale's advice. They have a lot more expertise than we do in these matters. And it, as you say, it will prevent this going backwards and forwards and things like that. So I think it will actually speed the process up. We don't have to take any notice of what it says, but I think they know what they're talking about. So if we're making some glaring errors, not deliberately, but obviously in our ignorance, then we need to know about it. So I think it would be very foolish not to take this advice.
Councillor
Brinkle? Yeah, I'm concerned how long actually this is going to take. But the simple reason is, obviously, if it goes out again, comes back. That's another 9 months down the road. And that is what does concern me, for the simple reason that we thought, with the consultant we had, that we were on the right path. Now, if we're not on the right path, what's going on? We want to know first which path we're supposed to go down through. It's no good sending something up if it's not right, as Margaret just said. So we need clarification before you go any further, in my opinion.
Councillor Pearson?
I've got a number of concerns. As far as I understand, we're at the point where we have to just go to the consultees, which are, you come back to me in a moment, and you met the other comments first. But I thought we were at a point where we could be sending out the consultees that we have a list of. As far as I'm aware, I didn't think you'd have to go back out to public consultation, because we've already listened to that. We only got 70 replies from the whole state. I'm very concerned about the timescale and the fact that if it goes to Stefan, who is very good at not replying to anything, that he might well sit on his desk for some time, and I've been having many dealings with Stefan. Ken Buffum and I had a meeting with Stefan last year, and basically, as far as Stefan was concerned, if it didn't fit in with Broxdale's local plan, then he wasn't in favour of it, which concerns me. The other thing that concerns me is that I know that Broxdale are anxious to get their local plan forward in July. If our neighbourhood plan needs to be done before they get their local plan, otherwise their local plan will supersede anyway and we've just wasted our time. So I have a lot of concerns. I think the problem is, while Stefan might be expert, he's also got vested interest in ensuring that his local plan and our neighbourhood plan don't contradict with each other, and I'm concerned that the reason he thinks it won't pass is because he doesn't want it to, because he doesn't want it to contradict his local plan. And that does concern me, and I'm of great concern as to whether he will look at it impartially or whether he'll look at it with a view to what Broxdale want out of it. And that really does concern me.
Has it got to
it?
Please through the chair.
Yeah. Sorry.
Sorry, I'm afraid.
No,
you're right.
No, so has it got to this second one? Is there anyone else? No, there isn't anybody else.
We're paying
a consultant,
aren't we?
Yeah.
Surely should know whether it will pass or not. Yeah.
That's the question. Sorry, yeah.
Yeah, my only other concern was seeing different versions of it, that all the stuff that Sussex Avenue needs to be taken out. I know some of it has, but it still looks like there's little bits in there. I think it's just tweaking, isn't it? That's the word we use nowadays, I don't know. Because people ask, you know, we put it in for a reason, and people have said take it out, and we agreed to do that, so that's what we're here for. There's still a little bit in there, and I thought it needs to be taken out, because we don't want it to act in public or whatever, and it confuses people, so it just needs going through it properly, it's like that, do you know what I mean?
Mr. Chairman, to reply to some of these comments, over the last fortnight I felt like Ken Martin's secretary. I can't make any changes to that report or plan, call it what you will, without his say so. He's the author, but he doesn't seem to have any of his own admin backup. And somehow, I'm not quite sure, but I ended up with the responsibility of making changes. I have tried to keep arm's length to this particular document, because at that time, as the previous proper officer of this council, if what was in the neighbourhood plan did not agree with what the town council wished, you would want, it would be the town council who would take priority. Although there is community involvement, it is the town council's neighbourhood plan. So I have kept arm's length. I can only make changes to it that I am directed to by the planning consultant that you have paid to do it. It has been indicated to myself and my colleague by Broxborough Council that the plan as it stands at the moment will not pass. Will not pass, PAWS, as yes, it does contradict what Broxborough are saying. And the understanding is that the plans have to mesh. So if you said, I've been told I'm not making any comments or anything about this because I've kept arm's length. However, they are offering to have a look at the final document before it goes out to consultation and let you know what they would consider any changes you make. If you decide not to go down that road, as I say, you don't have to take comments on board, but if you decide not to go down that road, and you do send it out to the consultees list, you will also, Broxborough are one of those consultees, as are all Broxborough councillors, all county councillors. If it then comes back with a whole lot of comments, which you then have to change, it will need to go back to the planning consultant, who will need to take this on board, he will need to meet with the steering group, they will need to go through all this, it will then need to come back to the council, it will then need to go back out again to all these consultees. This is what I have been informed, and I think that's my understanding as well from the last reading of the way they keep changing the roads, shall we say, for it. I just present it to you on behalf of the proper officer. If it's for the town council to decide what they want to do with it, not me, not Izzy, not the leader, the town council has to decide, do they want to send the amended copy when I find it, which I've looked at on Monday, because I'm not making it home the weekend, to the borough for their comments, or do they want to just speak out to consultation? Up to you.
Councillor Longman. On this issue, I still support Dan Wall's comments, because Tim's got an awful lot more to do. It's a bigger thing than people realise. We like a conclusion, an answer to our own requirements here. Unfortunately, from Tim's point of view, he could be administrating the loss of the parish council to over the neighbourhood plans. So I see all the neighbourhood plans in support as well as this one. So I think our far, far bigger thing that people will realise. So I should constantly support Jandall's comments, let them deal with it. Make up what you're owning, but afraid they'll be very, very patient before you get a proper answer. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
We employ a consultant who's said that he was guiding us what is right and what is wrong with putting this plan together, and he was quite happy as he went along and made changes, suggested changes, which changes were made. He seems to know very well what Roxborough seemed to want, and that's what we employed him for. Now, this is what I've just said, this isn't going to get us any further. It's a very difficult situation that we're in. Now, either we go ahead and get the steering group as soon as possible to actually get the consultant Ken in and thrash this out before it goes any further, Chair. Because if we decide tonight you either want to go one way or the other, I think we're jumping the gun a little bit. So I would suggest that the steering group, we meet Ken, we thrash out the problems that there are, but, and then come back to the council on the 27th of July.
Can I just do a point of clarification? It's the town council's neighbourhood plan. It's now at the stage where the town council need to make the decision of whether they wish it to go straight out to consultation or whether they wish it to go to Broxton before it goes out. In all honesty, Mr. Chairman, the number attending the steering group has dwindled to such a point. There's so few of them.
Council, yeah, I mean, this is the reason I've been asking. We went up the steering room meeting for ages, for the life of me. I don't know why. I mean, I know I've been asking, and I can't speak for others, but I've been saying our report when we have a meeting. We said everybody emailing each other with different things. I haven't that many documents. I don't even know what's going off anymore. And I've said numerous times, if we've got it printed out like this, and we sit around the table and go through it and go, that's right, that's wrong, that's right, that's wrong. Stephen should be, stop, not Stephen. Ken should be here because that's what we're paying him for. We've invited Stephen to loads of meetings and he's never been interested, and now we're kind of near the end of it, all of a sudden he wants to be interested. So, I mean, it's not like I said, however one votes, I'll agree with all of you, but we should have had more meetings than we've been having. You know, you go down to Toton, where they're doing this, they're meeting all the time. And like, you know, all the stuff they're doing and regular newsletters, we haven't been sending anything out. And I just think it's sad that something that's this important that we're doing, there hasn't been enough meetings discussing it. Emails isn't the same at all, and it's wrong.
But Mr. Chairman, can I clarify this point? I tried, as you know, my resignation's been in, and before my resignation period was up, I tried desperately to organise a steering group meeting. I could not get a date to get people together. I, at different points, suggested that Stephen Saunders should be invited to address the steering group, and no one wished me to do so. I said, I have kept arm's length from this. No one asked me to send that invitation out. There's nothing I could do about that. As for the Toton situation, I can't, the Toton is a forum, they've all kinds of different finance to back them up. I can't comment on that. I have, you would, if you wanted newsletters, if you wanted that type of background material, you would need to have found someone to do it. You couldn't even find anyone to do the administration of the group. That's why I found myself doing it. So I don't really know where you're going to get these people to do this work. At the moment, I think there's three active, I think you know there's three active members from the community on the steering group.
Council Pearson.
Just two things, really. It was originally things were sent to Stephen and he never replied to anything. I suspect the same will happen now. We won't get it back to Stephen. As regards the people on the steering group, the last time we had a steering group, as far as I know, there was myself, Richard, Simon, Teresa, Heather. We seem to make profit, not free, but. Heather has been inquiring with me and asking for information.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that she's not been doesn't mean she's not interested. She is still interested. The fact that there is up to meeting at a particular time doesn't mean anything. So she is interested. She does read all the things. She is running the Facebook page, but as nobody sends her anything, she can't put anything on it. So, I suspect it's up to the council to decide. My view is we're paying a consultant who doesn't know the ball game and doesn't know the way Broxton runs. I've seen Stephen perform at various other meetings. That's why I have my concerns. And he has not responded to anything that we've asked him of in the past. But that's my final comment. He does not respond.
Councillor? Yeah, well, I'm making a proposal here, or else we're going to go round all night. It's like a clock. And I'm suggesting that the steering group on this neighbourhood plan meets with Ken as soon as possible. Let's sit down and sort this out. Bring a report back to the council on the 27th, I think it is, of July, and let's get this thing moving. I can't see that whichever way other people are talking about, could go ahead and send it and all this sort of thing. I think we need to sit Ken down and get this thrashed out once and for all, or else we'll be waiting months and months and months.
Okay, what other proposals have you got,
sorry, like I say, we've tried having meetings with Ken, as Dave knows, we've sat here for over 40 minutes, weren't it, and he never even bothered showing up.
I know.
So I can understand both sides of the argument, like I say, simple as that. If we were to send it to Stefan, could we then say, look, you've got like a 2-week period to look at this, or you're not allowed to?
No.
Could we do?
You can tell
me. I mean, is it worth doing it and giving him a time scale and saying to him, well, I know, but I'm asking your advice because you know better than me. So is it worth just saying to him, right, we'll send it to you. Yeah, it might not, but then at least we'll know.
My opinion is Stefan will do what he wants to.
Absolutely.
But if we then turned around and said to him, right, okay, we'd like you to have a look because you've got a 2-week period to turn this around because we need to get it done and out. If he's not done it by then, can we then just automatically send it out?
I'll second it because I agree. Let's try it.
If he's going to offer the advice free, if he does it, great. And if he doesn't and he's messing us around, that's giving him a 2-week period. He can't be bothered to do it by then. We know where we stand. And then we'll just say, right, fair enough, let's just get it sent to the consultees, get it done, get it. Because, like I say, Ken, we are paying this gentleman. Why do we need some money to do this? And he doesn't know his job. So if he doesn't know his job, why have we employed him in the first place? But if it was me, I'd be saying, send it to Stefan, he's got a 2-week period to look at it, make his comments, get back to us. If he hasn't done part of it, it goes out straight to the consultants. Let's not fucking around dealing with it.
Just a training proposal.
Just Mr. Chairman, Madam Clark, to both of you. We've got two proposals in front of us. One proposal from Councillor Grindle that this goes back to a steering group meeting. Which I don't know who's going to clock it. Do you need a seconder for that one? The other proposal is from Councillor Mrs. Hull that we don't waste time with that, that we put the document to Broxburgh Council on Monday and ask for the comments back within 2 weeks. How do you want to take them?
I think.
Do you have a seconder for that one? Mr. Chairman, could I just ask you, because a new clerk this evening, this is a bit of a baptism of fire. Could you just...
Right, yeah. Okay, so we've got two proposals. So the first one is by Councillor Grindle, who proposes it goes to the steering group, meet with Ken, as soon as possible, and bring back a report on the 27th of July and get this thing moving. Yes. So does somebody want to second that?
We've got a seconder,
yes.
All in favour?
All in favour, please raise your arms.
I support you as well.
3, 4, 5. All against? 1, 2, 3, 4. Abstentions?
Right. I can't vote against them, I've got a nice tie on.
Right, in that case.
And I abstained.
Yeah, I did, yeah. I'm not central for council.
Call left.
In that case, it was dispatched to Stephen.
No, Michael, excuse me.
You want it to do both. You don't want. Sorry, it's a clarification. So you want it to go to the steering group.
I don't see why we can't vote proposals. Okay. One doesn't overrule the other.
Okay, that's fine.
Yeah. I don't see why we can't do that.
Okay, right.
And that's what I would propose. Yeah. We vote on both.
Okay, right, Mr. Chairman. The second proposal. Those in favour of the report going to the Borough Council on Monday.
For a 2-week turnaround.
A 2-week turnaround.
2, 9, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 4.
All against?
2 against.
You can't vote against your proposal.
Any abstainers?
No. Thank you. Okay, Mr. Chairman, so what you've proposed here for the point of clarification for the clerk's minutes is that you're going to arrange a steering group meeting and invite the planning consultants along to discuss this. And you're also going to, on Monday, send this document to Roxburgh Council for their comments. So hopefully, if you wait for a fortnight to have the meeting, hopefully you would have brought those comments back and you could take them. Is that what you're... If someone said to the meeting...
Precisely my idea.
Yeah, right, I'm with you. I'm following you now. Right, you will need to discuss with the clerk how you're going to clerk this meeting and what you're going to do with it. I'll leave that to yourselves. Okay? Thank you very much. Anyone else? Mr. Chairman, anyone else?
Yeah.
Anyone else? Any more comments on neighbourhood planning?
Sorry, can I ask one silly question then? Obviously, you mentioned about who's going to talk. Who's going to arrange the steering group meeting? Who arranges it?
It will be arranged through the town council, but it's actually who's going to clerk it. Because I found myself clerking this by default. But technically, the clerk should only attend this meeting to make sure that it's running along the same lines as what the town council wants.
So basically, Dave can take notes
because
he's
going to take
notes, couldn't
he? And then
obviously,
I'm quite happy to take notes if everybody's happy with me taking notes. Yeah. I've been trade union secretary.
You for a second?
No.
I'm happy to take notes and bring them back.
Councillor Pearson said he would be happy, so it's the steering group if he says that, and the clerk would just send to oversee it to make sure it wasn't falling out with town council policy. Okay?
Yeah.
Are we happy with that?
Yeah, that's
thank you.
Next item on meeting is allotment report. So
yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we have the allotments. Margaret and I have took an allotments inspection. And there were lots of vacant plots that needed trimming, etc. We've instructed the works to be done, and it was also because a feasibility study being undertaken to investigate the possibility of trimming, then ploughing, and then planting clover to suppress the weeds. There was a big discussion about that, so we said we would look into that. It was also requested that more regular inspections were carried out, but I would like to remind Council that the Town Council previously instructed the Town Clerk to reduce the number of inspections as they did not consider it a good use of the Clerk's time. So it is a very time consuming to do that. Can I also remind Councillors that only plot holders should be on the sites, and if plot holders take on guests, they should not go to any other plot. And the town clerk is the only person who can respect the sites. So I'd like to remind you of that. Thank you.
Any comments on the allotment, the council hall?
Yeah, like I say, I mean, we had a good meeting the other day, didn't we? Mm. But today he's gone away, he's going to do a few bits with which they asked, so he's going to look into that for us. Like I say, we did say we'd have a look about ploughing and see how much cost it was, because they were saying that if we quite ploughing more, laying the clover, then obviously it will hopefully save money in the long run. So it's something to look forward to, isn't it? And hopefully we can see if we can do that one for them. So yeah, I mean, it's quite a productive meeting. We did say we'll try and get, as soon as everything's been streamed, and we'll try and go out again. As he said, she'd be a account again and have a look. And then, if there are any other points to go then,
we can join them. And we agreed a meeting to be in December.
Yeah.
One
of the time, isn't it?
One of interim meeting to report back.
Yeah.
As well, so.
Any other comments on the bottom? So, on item 10, just meet your councillor.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Actually, this idea is very good, and I would support it. But truthfully, as some of the councillors, I don't have a backlog, but I do have enough casework to deal with. which comes to me direct. And I know that a lot of people contact the deputy chair, and but if the councillors wanted to actually run something like that, it's well worth doing. I would suggest if you do it, give it a trial, say a 3-month trial, and see how you get on. If it flowers and blossoms, brilliant. If it doesn't, then you'll find that majority of councillors will get their residents to contact them. So, but it is a good idea, and I would second a proposal by the leader.
Councillor McRae?
Yeah. I mean, I do this anyway, but so I do it where I do. I do think meeting people is a good idea. I am a copyrighted to meet the council. I think anyone can use that content. I can't charge you for doing it. But I personally don't think it's good use of the corner of yours. We've got availability in here. We should be trying to hire it out towards and try and get some money coming in. Because there's loads of different venues out there, and also some councillors can't make it at their time, so they might want to do their own surgeries in their own times at their own different places, like whether they use a cafe, whether they use their library, whether they, I don't know, sit in the middle of the town. It's up to each individual councillor. With media councillor, brilliant idea, you know, people want to come talk to us, as David said, people do contact you. But I do think if people want to do it yourselves, and we can try and find other uses for this place, because there's plenty of places out there you can meet people. You know, and also not everybody can make that time, so each individual council should do their own thing in their own time when they want them. That's just my thought.
So I think second on the other Councillor Pearson.
I would support the idea. I think it's an excellent idea that we should be more available to the general public as a whole. So I think it's an absolutely fine idea. Councillor Green will know we did used to do it every so often on a Saturday mornings in the library. And to be perfectly honest, most of the time I sat there on my own reading a book.
So did I.
Good
place for resort.
Oh yes. Delectable is the library selection is so bad I have to take my own books in. I support the idea of it. I think give it a whirl and see whether it works. And I certainly support the idea that we actually do that. But I mean, do it for a trial period, and I'm just sort of not casting sort of aspersions upon it, but I'm just warning that invariably people don't know. So therefore, it may be not a good place to hold it here, depending on. But I support the idea of it.
Yeah, like you say, it's just an idea. I know you already all have your cat meetings, Richard has his one famous court and things like that. And it's not to say that don't stop them, you know, don't stop it. And we all know people ring us up and tell you and things like that, obviously, he's in the street. It was just I thought, right, well, even if it was like once every 8 weeks, something like that, just for an hour and a half while the office is open, even if we're just sitting there in the corridor, it makes no difference. And like I say, somebody might not even turn up, but even if that one person turns up, at least then you can go on the website and at least it's making us accessible. Do you know what I mean? Like some people don't go on the website, older generation don't use it, so even if they're just popping in, sometimes we like to pop in for a minute. It's just a suggestion. We could try it, and if it doesn't work, it doesn't work. Simple as that.
I wasn't sure the council offered it.
No, just one quick question, you know, in terms of meeting your council, does that mean you're going to have a road for it, or are you just going to meet anybody who's available?
Well, I say, I'll come to the first one, simple, I think
the
simple
yeah, 90. Yeah, that's how you're going to organise it.
I was just thinking, if anybody would like to come, then great,
but
then if it started working, then
so
we'd have a road for it.
So keep
it
as
well,
an
avenue
for council to reach the end.
Yeah.
I'm actually talking about a meeting chair of council.
Yes.
It's an excellent idea.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, yeah.
Sorry.
Different
council. Sorry to reply. Yeah, it's not just about a party thing. It's for the town council. It should be whoever's free on that particular day to make it great.
We have done it. We have done it here.
Yeah,
I'll
have
the
immediate MP
on
to
But it was a party. But I think if it has a mixed group, I think we've got something for everybody.
Yeah.
And you know, it shows that we're working together.
it's the state of town council, it's we're all parties, it doesn't matter what party we are, yeah. As we know, I try and find something council. If I'm not sure, I'll go to Jan, I'll go to Chuck, go to Ray, I'll go to anybody to say, like, well, can you help out? Can you do this? A bit of advice. And that's what it should be, not specific people doing one thing. It's, we should all work together.
Councillor London.
I agree with the man down the Jan. Should it be a non-party political thing? I think if you're going to have to talk with it, just make sure it's hold you the word non-political fellowship.
Good point.
Councillor
Pratt.
I think
Grindle
try.
Request for working parties. Just put on the agenda the request for the meeting of the town council. David first, so Councillor Grimby.
I'm actually agreeing with working parties, especially for the HS2 and for traffic and transport. I've been on with other councillors here on traffic and transport for quite some time, and we have achieved, believe it or not, some things, and a lot of other things we haven't. And that's unfortunate, but if we don't keep going with these things, where local councillors, where local people come and be able to advise and tell and suggest what we should be looking at, what we should be doing on the traffic and transport, and getting speakers in, getting obviously police and bus services and other organisations. And I would support this wholeheartedly. The second part, Mr Mayor, is HS2, very important to Stapleford. I believe that we should have set up and continue on with a proper HS2 and a traffic and transport, and I think that will be enough for us to get on with to begin with. And if members are interested, then I hope they'll support the traffic and transport and the and HS2.
I think that's all Pearson was
making. Yeah, I've just got a few points to make. I can probably make my comments about a few bits. I'm a little bit concerned about the wording that the leader of the council has been approached by members with regards to setting up capital working parties. I mean, both those working parties have been working. I find the first sentence about a little bit disingenuous. I know the leader has spoken to me about those and suggesting that they should be capital working parties so that it does not involve the town clerk. That I can go along with. In fact, the only reason the traffic and transport was actually officially clerked was at the previous town clerk's insistence, and we never did get the minutes from the last meeting. I know that the Bartons in particular asked me... Thank you. I know that the Bartons representative particularly asked me at Remembrance Sunday that we continue it, and said that one of the reasons he didn't want the meetings was because he didn't receive any income. I don't know whether that's true, but he was certainly keen to agree to continue because he felt it was very useful. I think both of the those mid groups have been important, and they have, well, HS2 will be important, I would suspect. Traffic and transport, we have achieved things. I would just like to make a couple of other comments. Firstly, I think it's important that the council is involved in a number of these things. If we're not, we become in danger of just running allotment and Remembrance Sunday. We already know that the county council is very much in favour of removing all district and borough councils, and Kay Cox was speaking to people this week. We also know that the city would love to take over this area of Broxton. And if we're not involved in things other than just allotments and Remembrance Sunday, then we're in danger of having no justification for existing and having 18 councillors here. So I think it's important that we are there doing things for the people. That's what we're elected to do. And I think it's important that we're involved in those sort of things. As regards the two groups, I find quite happy that it shouldn't be clerked or serviced by the town. I've got no reason why it should be, as long as there are some notes produced and circulated. And I don't see any reason why we can't organise such meetings ourselves. And as a casual meeting. I do have a slight concern about Part D. Because if it's a casual meeting, invitations to outside speakers, I'm quite sure nobody said they've been invited to outside speakers, but people have been invited from various bodies, should be discussed with the town council to establish whether or not it would be appropriate. It seems to me that that is wanting it both ways. It's either a casual meeting that we report back on, or it's an official council meeting. I don't really see how we can have a situation where who we invite to discuss things with has to be decided by the council. It's either a casual meeting or it isn't. And I don't really see that there is any need for D to be there. Right, I've had my little thing.
Yeah, I'm absolutely baffled why these are on here and we're discussing it, because we had meetings last year and we set up a state for traffic and transport working group, and we've had a couple of meetings. We had a meeting in January, I've requested the minutes numerous times and all my emails have been ignored. The minutes were taken and I'd still like to see them. It was agreed that the traffic and transport committee would take it after the CAP meeting, so anything raised at CAP meetings, we ain't going to forget, because sometimes we do, we bring up the next day. The meeting, we've been meeting, it's already set up, so I don't understand how we can set something on that already exists. We didn't get rid of it, it's still there. We also set up an HS2 working group, and when we had the meeting in here, a few councillors was unable to attend, and we've got minutes for it. They took the minutes because no one else could, and we've met. And we do need to have another meeting with that, because we've been to HS2 and been up here, they're up trial at the minute, and Chris and myself had seen them earlier, and there's all this to read, and I've got maps printed out and everything, and again, we do need to have an HS2 meeting, and there's some more stuff coming out in October, so something kind of now-ish, especially when you find out that they want to build a pond on top of UPS and all that lot down there, and the scrapyard down here, they want to turn it into somewhere to keep the tools. So that's going to have a big impact on a lot of businesses in Stapleford. And these are maps we've been given today. I've got small ones here, and I've got massive ones here, and if anyone wants to have a look afterwards, I ain't got a problem putting them out. But these groups already exist, and nobody's ever said we've closed them groups down, they're not running anymore, we've just not had a meeting. So I don't understand how we can be saying, let's set a group. I can't go to Broxton and say, well, let's set up the planning committee. We've already got one. And these groups are brilliant, they do work. And if people can't come, it doesn't matter, but if they can come, even better. You know, they're open to anybody. But they are there, and they have been working, and we have been doing stuff. And like I said, we've never been sent the minutes from January. They were taken, and I'd still like to see them even today. I don't mean right now, but these groups already exist. How can we be saying set a group up that's already there? I don't get it. I really don't. It baffles me.
And I'll say further, I would like to see them continue, as it were.
Yeah.
And
two meeting. I think I have discussed this with the leader of the council as well. I didn't realise that it wasn't proper.
It was.
Well, turned it on.
So, because the leader of the council was there taking minutes, you were there, Councillor Grendel. We elected a chair and a vice chair, and I can't understand why more people weren't there and it wasn't, or why it was undemocratic. So if that can be explained to me, I'm quite happy. I mean, if it was inappropriate, then it was inappropriate and I won't take part in it, but it wasn't.
There's obviously a bit of confusion, obviously I'm getting confused. But the HS2, I know it's already gone ahead, because isn't it as that? I know you've always the trail grants, what you've always said. I know about that, I've heard about it. I've never been to one, because I'm really invited, but you know what I mean.
So
it's all right, you got it there, it's not a problem.
Yeah.
But surely if anything comes to, like say, Izzy's got 20 hours a week, that's all she's got. So as long as she's not parking it, that's the only problem we've got, is that we just can't afford, especially at the minute, because she's still learning, she's got an awful lot to learn, an awful lot to do, so she can't park it. See, that's the problem with that one. I don't have an issue with it, I'm sure everybody doesn't, but if you have the meetings, then you sort of like, is it open to anybody?
Yeah.
Where does it go on?
Yeah.
Does it go on the website? So well, who's choosing the dates?
When we spoke about the traffic and transport last year, I don't know who was here or not, so I can't remember who was here, but we said, let's do it the day after the CAT meeting, for the reason that if anything's raised, because sometimes, things do get raised at CAT meetings about traffic and transport, the idea being, we do it the day after, and we agreed that last year, and that's the day we met, so as far as I'm aware, the next one, because it's every 3 months, so it's 1 hour every 3 months, that was. The HS2 meeting, we met and we kind of just set it all up and we said, let's find out some information and we'll do a meeting, because there's no point having one of them every 3 months, because we don't know stuff every 3 months. Like, we found out loads of stuff today, so you will kind of have a meeting. And they said the next lot of stuff to be released is going to be around about October. So it's probably 2 or 3 meetings a year on that one. But the track, everything's, I don't get why we're doing it. I'll go watch you tell it, because we've already agreed all this.
All right, so anyway, the traffic transport,
like
I say,
it's
the day after. You know when your CAT meetings are.
Sorry?
You know when your CAT meetings are for the whole year. So then can't we go on the website?
Well, we always try to do that. We've always asked and tried to do things like that. I always advertise them, but if others don't, that's not my problem.
Right, so can we suggest it goes on to the... If Richard knows when the CAT meetings are,
let me know.
We can advertise the traffic and transport so it's open to more people. Is it open to anybody?
Because we've said that before, didn't we? People wanted, if members of the public wanted to put light like this in City, they could. But if it was people that was part of a group or something, like Pedals, I'll use that as an example because he comes, they could come, and then obviously anyone else, because they know it's happening, they can contact the council and say, I don't know, I want to raise a concern about such and such, and then you discuss it around the table, don't you?
Okay, so if
you
can give
this
chat meeting, so it's on for the whole year, then. Like I said, obviously, we can't afford, but she's trying to learn the job, so we don't need it. So if somebody's there to take the minutes, that's not a problem. But then can we have those minutes then brought to the next town council meeting? So everybody who can't make it is aware of that. That's all it is. It's a bit of a clarification, because I have never sat here in all my years and actually been told what's going off at traffic transport.
So that's because it was always run, it was a county council thing, so Stan and Jackie did it as county councillors, but the current county councillors didn't want to do it, they're always invited, but just don't come, so,
Excuse me, because, as you're aware, you cannot promise anything there, you cannot do anything there, it has to be, it's got to come to full council anyway, hasn't it?
Yeah, but when we had the track and transport in the past, like Stan would say, right, I don't know, everyone said, well, the white line around the corner somewhere, then he'd go away and action all them things, because it gets sent away to whoever, let's say the county council, for example, and someone will say, yes, you can have your line, no, you can't, that kind of thing.
Right. So all I'm saying is, all we need is a lot more clarification now.
Yeah, of course.
when we're having meetings,
what's
going on, let's get a little bit more involved here so that everybody knows what's going on. And then
no, that's not what it's been anyway.
So it's just on.
Can I make it clear, when I came to the HS2 meeting, I thought it had gone out to all councillors. That was my my impression. That's why I came. And I was quite surprised at the very poor turnout. The leader at the time was here. So therefore, I thought everything had been done properly and in an appropriate way. If they've gone out to the other councillors, then I don't understand a problem. As long as everyone knows and is able to, we're a democracy. You're all invited. It's entirely up to you whether or not you come. If you don't come, well, then there were minutes taken.
Councillor London.
Thank you, Chair. Must have been 18 months ago or something like that, when I first attended the first one at Tram. What members don't know, a number of us went earlier than they went to the side room, and we had no doubt whatsoever it's going to go ahead. Now, no matter what anybody said, all the way down the line, it's going to go. Just slight bit of a big fortune. They might want to keep the line a little bit, but they can keep the line as straight as possible. That has undertaken no working out. We are talking years ahead here. So I really don't see why you want to work in groups. You're totally beyond me. Perhaps in 5 years, 10 years' time, perhaps. We are talking many years ahead. Most of them won't even be here when it comes through. Thank you.
I've got to look between you two guys.
As far as I'm aware, the traffic and transport group minutes would be circulated. The last one should. The previous, first one should have been, the only reason it has to be is because we haven't got the minutes. And I can figure out for them. So we're not going to go into that. That's a water under the bridge. The important thing is there's no reason if we know we've got a clerk on ourselves that we can't go down that way. As regards the HS2, it's my understanding that when we, the HS2 gentlemen came, and in the discussions that we had, that we would set up a casual working group. Yeah. It was agreed that it would be set up because Margaret said that she could not coordinate and take minutes, and I said that I would take the minutes. Which is why we went ahead. Now, that was not minuted. As a minute, I haven't got the minutes at that time. It was my understanding that that was what was there and it was open to everybody. Mm. We decided not to make a record of date because we thought we would have a meeting, see who was interested, and at that first meeting, and I have got the minutes at home which I can type up now, but unfortunately I didn't get them typed up because I wasn't in a position to as much as on that. But it was agreed at that meeting that because we hadn't got sufficient information, we wouldn't set a date for another one until we had more information, which is now, as far as I can see, the situation where we probably have got more information, mm-hmm. and that it is worth getting together to do that.
Absolutely.
The whole purpose of having such a working group means that councillors who've got that interest who are available can attend and report back, rather than some people thinking, well, I couldn't care less about this and I don't want to be involved. Mm. And therefore, it means that it's interested people who are doing it, rather than some people who perhaps aren't so interested or don't believe in it or whatever. And that's the important bit about it. I appreciate what Councillor Lawler was saying, and I think things will change. And I'm sure what he's sort of saying is, right now, if this council exists in 4 years' time, I'll be amazed. No, if Broxdale exists in 4 years' time, I'll be amazed. So, that is part of the reason that we should be showing that we are doing things for the people and that we are interested in the thing, and that's part of it.
Councillor Hall?
No. not like I say, I have no issues with any of these things going ahead. It's just I would like a bit more clarification so that everybody, if they want to be involved, can be, rather than just certain people. We've got a new website, so like I say, if Richard gives us the list of when these dates for the traffic and transport are going to go ahead, and if there's any, like, let's use the website. If they're going to invite somebody from Pebbles or Barton, let's make people aware, dates, times, and things like this, but also can we then, for that sort of thing, inform Izzy, and then like I say, it can go a letter out to the council and say, look, you know, a bit of a reminder, do you want to come? Such as being invited, just let's make it a little bit more open for everybody to attend, because sometimes we miss things, don't we? But and the same with the HS too. Yes, let's have the meeting, but again, let's make it more. I know Izzy can't park them because obviously she hasn't got the time, but let's make it more accessible for everybody to actually to if they want to take part, they can do.
We had a meeting today at Trout, HS2, and there were lots of people there, and we spoke to some of the IELTS people and that, and they said, yeah, you know, it's kind of coming in and that. And we said, well, we've got to see what we can get out of them. But they do want to work with town councils, they do want to work with borough council, and then they made that blatantly clear today. And there's like things on here, like I said, I don't know if you've seen these maps, but like I said afterwards, I ain't got a problem, I don't mind hanging around 10 minutes and showing people. There's some things on here, like the bridge, that down at the way down there, is the fact that Bezel Lane's going to be one of the main ways getting down there, and we've said that for years, and he basically said to us, didn't he, that it'll be wiped out down there because they've got to widen it. So these are all things that we need to be talking about because it affects the people in Stapleford, and if people don't want to be part of it, it don't matter. I mean, I'd like to think that everyone around Stapleford's going to be there when it's there, I hope we are. But it doesn't matter whether you support us or not, if it's going to come, let's see what we can get. Because I know we've got a big fat pot of money for community groups and stuff, and I want some of that staple for it. So, you know, the money's there, we've got to talk to them, otherwise we'll spend it in other areas. And then they said that today, didn't they?
Yeah.
They want to work with different groups, whether it's councils, communities, whatever, because there's a ton of money there to put in your areas. And when we raised concerns about the high street, they said they're more than willing to come and sit with us and talk about these things. You know, and I'm not going to say speed bumps in that, but I kind of mentioned that, you know, as I always do. But they want to come and talk about that because they've got their own little subgroups where they've got people out. Every now and again you'll see things really across the road, and there's cables. And I'm not saying it's them all the time, but a lot of it is them. But if we don't have these meetings and we don't sit down with them and talk with them, because the guy who met, I forget his name, the guy with all the...
Paul.
He wants to come back and talk to us all. He's the guy that can answer the questions that we want to ask. And I know David's always got lots of questions to ask him because we have to. But this is such a serious project. I mean, if you look around, A52, the bit going through, the boundary, the train bridge as it is at the minute, and all other things as well. We need to crack on with this because if we don't do it now, they're just going to do what they want. They do want to listen to us. And even if we just ask something and get something and we ask for something to be changed, it changes a little bit. We've done our job, haven't we? And like I said, with our meetings, if one person comes and they want a hedge cut in and someone gets it done from it, it's worth it, isn't it? So even if we only get something minimal, at least we've put our standpoint and we've tried, haven't we? You know, it's so important, it's unbelievable. But they do want to work with us, and I think that's brilliant.
Councillor Gould.
Right. Well, I think there's been a lack of communication in the past. That's down to all of us. I think there's a bit of grandstanding as well, like by some councillors. And I think we need to work together.
Yeah.
We're all in it together, you know, it's the town council and we should be working for the town's vote. I think there should be more communication. I think when things are being done, then we all need to know about it. We need to know, we need to get our heads together about meetings, and it should be a joint decision. It's not down to one person to do this. Any of us, you know, that's where I think the understanding comes in, and I think that's wrong. Certainly, you know, I think the leaders of the council, it's disrespectful to them when we go off and do things
at a tangent, it is wrong. And we need to be liaising more with the leaders of the council. And when we decide to do something like this, I think we're a whole group and not just individuals who are wanting to make a name for themselves.
HS2 is very, very important. We all agree. It really is important. But like I say, again, on both, it, on anything really, everything, let's use our website properly. Let's get everybody involved. If they want to be involved, let's make sure they're all aware. If they don't want to come, that is up to them, then that is their decision. And if they don't wish to have a meeting because they can't or whatever, they can. HS2 is very, very important. And like I say, we really do need to make sure that we get the best for Stakeford. It's as simple as that. So yes, I agree to the meetings. So the only thing I'm saying is we just can't let these clock them because we can't. At those meetings, they cannot make decisions as such. Can important decisions cannot be made. They have to come to full council. That's all I'm saying. So more clarification. Let's ask everybody if they'd like to come. And then please, like I say, no decisions can be made at those meetings, not unless they come back to full council, as we are aware.
Councillor Pearson? Yeah, I've got to keep going around, I think. I'd like to propose that we separate these working groups, the basis of A, B and C, and perhaps a rephrasing of item D. Because we can often get speakers to come at short notice, you can get people to come in the middle of the day. I think the important thing is, I think A, B and C cover the fact that we're recognising still a capital meeting, we can come back to the council, and if we find we have a productive discussion with somebody, we can suggest that they come to a meeting. Rather than it being decided of who we invite beforehand, we could almost vet the person or maybe a waste of space and it's not very good. So I'd like to propose that we set up both those things. Let's forget item D, we're responsible people, we work for the town, hopefully we all are. And that we can do that and come back and work on that.
Before the proposal to the other people, the three other people have to speak.
Yeah, I was going to say something similar today, but I was going to say set them up because, as far as I'm concerned, they're already going. I think keep them going as they are, but obviously with what we've discussed about the dates and the other stuff, I'll let you know, I'll message you tonight, I'll tell you in a minute if you want me to. We'll do it.
Email.
I'll email you, okay? Yeah, that's no problem. And as Dave said, take the DVD out and then just kind of like carry on, but with what we've spoken about, I wouldn't say reset them all because they're already going.
Yeah.
You can't reset them all because they're already going. But then put these kind of ground rules in there, I ain't got a problem with that at all.
Councillor Rindle?
Yeah, I would second Councillor Pearson.
That's it. Have you got any other comments before you go to the proposal?
No.
Sorry, that's it. I don't know if it's mine. Do you have the proposal?
Right. So, the proposal is to set up the working party, don't I?
Well, no, keep continue the working party.
Sorry, I've treated it. Sorry,
yeah, continue the working party.
The working party with using the A, B and C that's in the minutes there. Recognise it's a casual meeting, report back to a town council meeting, and invite people to meetings, if necessary, to the full town council on that.
On the website,
okay. On the website, yeah.
And the proposal for that was what Councillor Pearson?
Three votes. Okay, so there's all in favour. Those against?
Abstentions? Traffic and highways issues in Spain. Has that been covered at the last?
Yeah. very quick one, because obviously if we go to John about that.
Yes, I heard. Okay, give you a Christmas present at Christmas. Because of the fatality on the road 3 or 4 weeks ago, the county council will not touch it. I was working very hard to get rid of the ones. They're all the preliminary meetings and get to meet the legal staff. Then we'll go, go to the meeting. We've got to the decision. And got all my arguments sorted out. Everything ready. It has looked promising. The cost of removing them, the jackhammer called a sponge and a brush. Unfortunately, the fatality is a total disaster now. The heart of Main Street is a taboo subject across party. Nobody will now discuss it. I'm hopeful I can salvage something when the official police report comes out, but I'm very, very doubtful. One of the is a I was saving this if the discussion was going to not where we would like. I would have suggested they do what they've done towards the road,
yes.
Which is an area I treat like the plague. I go miles round it, I will not go down it. But I was just going to suggest that for here. But that would be just a backhander. Because we don't get rid of one trade crippling system. I think bringing in another one. So we've got the speed to cripple the trade instead of the humps, which will never damage the trade. But unfortunately, the Christmas present's not going to come. Perhaps in several years' time, might be another go. Just point out, this is the only town in the Rochester Borough with humps on the main trading routes. It's nothing in Kimberley. It's got some blacks in Eastwood. And it's in other towns of the county as well. Unfortunately, we're stuck with them. Because this chamber has had an anti-hunt policy all these years. Unfortunately, the Christmas present is not going to happen. Thank you.
Thank you, Councillor. So it'll be interesting to see the police report as to whether the hunts would have been
in the Councillor. Overall, salvage some of the
crap. Yes, it's not a Councillor longer than agreement with funds. This is something obviously I've been asking for ages, and when we had those your statements with your ideas or whatever we called them, and quite a few people came on it, I think you two came in the past room, but and one of the things we mentioned was making the statement for the 20 mile an hour long now should be taking the speed up to put some cameras on. And all these ideas have already been sent to the county council when we did all that stuff ages ago, didn't we? We had some meetings and that. And all the traffic and transport meetings we've had. That's something that we've been raising, and that's going back to when Stan chaired in and he did a good job, that's why I wanted to carry it on. But I know Councillor McGrath's not here tonight, I can't speak for him as such, but that's, you know, I would say, can we put something on traffic and transport? That is what it was, because when we was at the Jambos of Community Safety at Brockstone, one of the questions that John asked was, I think it was 20 mile an hour through the street and this and the other, but he was told that wasn't the appropriate place, it makes sense to do it at the Traffic and Transport Committee, because that's what we've got, Brockstone, you know, they do their thing, we do ours, it's our town, isn't it? So that's what he would have been asking for tonight, and I still think that's something we need to fight for, so whether this town council can agree and we write to the county council and say to them, look, this is, you know, I know someone's got run over, and that's very sad, of course it is, and we never want that to happen. But the speed bumps, it's just out, it's parted towards killing the high street because people are going up and down Brookhill Street to avoid the high street, and that's having a detrimental effect on the businesses. And this is what we're saying. So, I mean, if it was me, I'd be down there with tin and red paint and paint it from the Chequers all the way to the train bridge red. And if you're on the red, you do 20 mile an hour. And if you go more than that, the camera pins you, and you get a big fat ticket. That would probably work. The speed bumps, we did a petition, and every single business from one signed it because that's what they want as well, because it is affecting the high street. So, you know, this is something, it's not new, it's something we've been asking for ages, and just because you get told no, then you go back and ask twice, don't you? So we do, I would like everyone to support that, and I do think we should instruct the town clerk to write to the county council and say, look, this is something that we want. And I knew if John was here, this is what he'd be asking as well. Like I said, we wrote it in the week and asked for the agenda. So try and get 20 mile an hour on the last year and remove the speed bumps. And I think we've just got to keep asking until it happens because it's our town. So, yeah, you know, I'm glad you agree with me on that.
Councillor Brindle.
Yes, this humps has been coming up by our council, and quite right, on
we've always messed about up and down, and yes, you can get rid of them, no, you can't. Government said in 2017 it's up to local authorities to take the pumps away or not. Stapleford Council paid a lot of money many years ago for a feasibility study. We've still got the humps there. And obviously, as John knows, that it's been a thorn in the side of Stapleford for many, many years, and hopefully one day we'll be able to get rid of them. The people of Stapleford want them gone. It's just that the politicians and the county don't. Up to 2015.
Councillor Pearson?
I think I'm in sympathy with the thing. I think perhaps on the basis of what Councillor London said, now is perhaps not the time for us to write to the County Council, because I'm sure what they will do is come back and say there's been another fatality there and whatever. Therefore, I think perhaps at the minute the time is not right, because we don't know, I certainly don't, I'm sure nobody else does, exactly why that accident happened. I'm sure it could probably, it's got nothing to do with the hooks either way. But I suspect the timing is probably not a good thing, because they will just, as Council London's been saying, just bury it. I think what would be useful is that if Council London could keep us in touch and suggest when it would be a good time for us to ride, because that would then no doubt help anything that he wants to do. And I think that if he could do that and say, look, it's a good, now probably isn't a good time, but now would be. I don't want us to leave it too long, but I think it's important that we do that, and I'd be great, and I'm sure the rest of the council would, if Council London would keep in touch with us about that, and that we would then be giving him some support in what he's been trying to achieve.
Yeah, just to reiterate what I said earlier, across the party, that main street now is a taboo subject, yeah. Very serious taboo subject. Like I said earlier, if the official police report comes out, I'll try and salvage something.
That's right.
But I'm not at all hopeful. And I agree, you could be wasting your time contacting or writing in. They'll come to me anyway. And to the people who are, I might not be home now on this issue. It's very embarrassing to bring it up now.
Let's try and see if we can give
in
you
future,
the backing when you
we'll need see what I've said. Anything we can do is hopefully I'll try and salvage something. When the official police report comes out.
And that's the time.
But, you know, I can try then, but I'm not hopeful.
As a mayor, I'm not supposed to comment, but the accident happened with the pumps there. Anyway, wait for the police report.
Yeah.
It wasn't nothing serious for you. Pumps, I was there, I'm the one that ran from the defib for the gentleman, so I was there when it all happened. It was horrible. But that's another story. But getting money towards it, when we spoke to these guys today, and we were talking about the speed bumps, and I'm not saying they said here's a cheque, because that would be lovely, wouldn't it? But the impression they said, wouldn't it, that they don't want to speed up staying either. This is why it's important to have the traffic and transport meetings and to have the HS2 meetings and talk to these people, because we don't want people going up Toton Lane and down Buck Hill Street. We want them going through the town centre. I know, all right, they're going to clear off, but also the HS2 is not about how quick you can get to London, it's about how quick you can get to Stapleford. That's the main thing, do you know what I mean? So we've got to get people coming here, and we want them going along the high street. We've got some cracking shops, we want people going in them, you know. So that's why we've got to keep having about HS2. But yeah, I do think, you know, let's bring it up down the line a bit later, which makes sense, and that is a good suggestion. Mm-hmm. You know, we don't want to upset people. That's it on that.
We can't do anything further on this, so there are any comments in there. So, correspondence.
John and I spoke to you about it, and obviously we can understand now why we can't remove the road pumps, but would it make a difference if we actually suggested 20 miles per hour and wrote to
It's a very, it's a taboo. I keep saying it, but people will listen. It's very embarrassing now. I went to see the geo placements. That's happened. Sorry.
Well, I don't know what I'm saying.
if that's what Amanda's proposing, I'll second that, because yeah, I do think it is the time now to write in and say that. We've got nothing to lose, have we, on the 21 hours?
Yeah,
we've got nothing to lose at all.
And say no more, we'll just totally ignore us.
Yeah,
we'll try, aren't we? Surely, even if we just write to them and just say about the 20 miles an hour.
I will wait until the official police report comes out. Sorry, Chair.
Well, I'll second you on that, Amanda, anyway.
Councillor John Long is quite right. We ought to wait. Probably the report won't come out until September or October. We should wait till then and then slap it in.
And just spoke on it
about 20 miles per hour. Yeah.
Sorry, can I ask a question then? So why will it take so long?
Inquiries take a lot of time.
All right, I'm just thinking, surely.
Let me.
Yeah, wait a bit. Excuse me. So surely, like I say, if we can get the report, and then would you mind that? So like, if we wait for the report, see what happens. I can't see why. I mean, it makes no difference to me. The road bonds have got nothing to do with that accident. I can't see it.
That's not how I spoke to
Yeah, well, it's probably, that's the way I see it. The way I see it is the road bonds are there.
Of course, it's I know the situation in any big council like that.
Yeah.
It's nobody did cross fault again.
Me, it's just, I'm sure even if you had 20 miles an hour, it would make no difference. If you've got a 20 mile an hour sign up there and they've got to adhere to that, then that hopefully would be in the best interest of all of us. We might slow down and actually see what shops are.
I did it because it's important, obviously. And to get the 20 mile an hour, I don't think it's quite the right time to be avoided it.
Okay, then shall we go to
Unless Amanda wants to make a proposal.
Do you want to propose anything?
I'd still like to, even if we just turn on
any of the
lights. No, obviously, I know we can't. Even if they just totally ignore us, can we at least make the suggestion of, do you want to ask Izzy to write to the county council, saying the state of the council would like it to be the 20 mile.
You second it. So those in favour, can you raise your hands, please?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Those against?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I think that you're going for the base
report. Right, sorry.
Could we take the vote again, please, in favour? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Against, could you put your hands up high, please? One. Abstentions? 1, 2, and John?
2.
3, John.
Okay. Can I just ask one thing, though? When it comes to the traffic control issues, you know, instead of it having issues, can we bring it back to like we used to do? It's like, if you've got specific areas you want to do, even if we do it in wards, what do you think to that? I mean, rather than doing it, we'll be here forever, we did it in hold issues, but if we could do it in wards, what do you suggest to that one? What do you think?
I'd say if someone's got a specific issue, like that, and they...
Particular road or something like that. Can we do that then?
I think, personally,
I think we're just chasing a tail, really. They're not interested in doing it. I think they should write for the government, not the county council.
Okay.
I think it should be direct to the government.
But Ray, if we, instead of having traffic and climate issues and we burn the whole town, would you? I think it would be better if we either did it like we used to do, and we either did specific roads, like you know, we used to bring the woodies road and things like that, or would you like it in wards? Would you prefer to go back to...
Well, in that case, it's going to be who shouts the loudest.
Should we do a specific
issues?
Mr. Chair, clarification for the clerk for the minutes. What has just been decided to go back to what you would do for a few years there. If anyone has an item that they wish to raise under traffic and transport, they contact the clerk by the Monday prior to the meeting, so
the week before,
dispatch, and let the clerk know what the item is, and then it will be on a specific item, so we don't have this open-ended that's going to going on all night.
So that's what the traffic and transport meeting's for, isn't it? To be an open-ended thing, isn't it?
That's
yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah,
thank you very much, thank you.
Item 14, plan.
13. Okay, so you all have been emailed about the HS2 events.
Yeah.
One was today,
yeah.
And the next one's 27th of June.
Okay.
The second one is a local geological site. You all have information. Any comments for that? And regarding the GDPR, the General Data Protection Regulations, we did invite the members from Roxham Borough Council to see if they could come and talk to the members. However, they did not work on a Friday night.
No, of course not.
So I'm afraid that's his note about that.
The leaflet that we sent to members of Roxham Borough Council, and you can meet them to the email and to the door.
We have made information available to people, and if you want them to go to anyone, you can email them to
if people want them. Again, point of clarification for the minutes. Groups of our accounts are not available to come and speak at Friday night meetings. What they've said is they've sent copies of the documents that were sent to members of Roxton Borough Council. These can be emailed out to members if they want them. The reason they haven't been emailed out is we were still waiting to see if they were going to come to a meeting. If they came to a meeting, they would have brought hard copies.
So if they want them, let me know.
Let you know, and they'll be emailed out.
Councillor Craig. Yeah, I'm sure I'll grab a stack of hard copies as well. I mean, I'm no expert in GDPR. Of course, I'd be a solicitor making absolute fun of money. I don't think anyone's an expert in it. It is dead important. I don't know if people know what it is. And I would like to suggest that we ask the guy to come in a daytime one day when people are available. And it doesn't have to be a council meeting. We can just sit here because I'm sure these questions, I mean, I'm pretty up on that, on GDPR. And it's dead important. I wouldn't like to see anyone around this table do something and get into trouble because of it, because it's really serious. And it, you know, you can get into serious trouble for it. If he's willing to come out in a daytime one day, I know everybody can't be there, but if there's one or two people from different parties and that, and they, you know, give a few questions to them, and we can ask the guy, it's that important, he doesn't need doing it. Because I always thought councillors were supposed to be trained councillors as well, actually, so this could kind of be part of that. I don't know, he's willing to do it, because I spoke to him.
I did actually, when I got the email from Margaret and Izzy, I actually made that same suggestion. I said, can't you do it at a different time, even if it's in the day when the town council's open, so we're not going to pay for staff or anything, so I can put it out to anybody to see if they're interested. So I did actually ask that
question. So, instruction.
Obviously they needed instruction, so if we'd like to go, if we'd like to go up, propose it, if we'd like, that we'd like to invite them. Whenever it does it, if you'd like to attend a Friday afternoon session or whatever,
yeah.
I think it's on Friday.
Yes, the date's off,
yeah. Yeah, so when it's free.
No, I'm saying that. It's very important, Mary, so I need to do it.
Sorry, can I make a suggestion? Sorry. Once he gets back to us, could you email everybody, all the councillors, asking which specific dates he's free? Who's free on that day, who would like to attend, and then we can then say, well, I'll get back to you, get to Thursday, was eight to us, if we could do that, please.
Matt, I'll get some hard copies and bring them down here as well, and if people want to pick them up, because they're here, I'll be telling you.
Right, so can we vote on that then now, please? So, there's four.
I'll get a count to you.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Against.
There's against?
No. Abstentions?
No, just my
abstentions?
No. Yeah. No. There's my interest either. Is that protected in small groups? There's 66 of us.
So we're moving on to planning applications for the three of them to consider here.
Yes, Mr. Chairman, just before you go and through you again for a quick clarification for the minutes, the third item is not on Roxburgh Council's website, and I tried to change it from this morning. We couldn't change it on Roxburgh Council, and I tried from home this morning.
I can't
see
it. I'll put it on there.
I spoke to Councillor Richard McCrae and Deputy Leader. I had no way of getting any plans off the box on that one, as the market has said. And that's why I went to the Leader of the Council for the meeting and asked her not to put it on. That's the third one, because there's no plans for us to discuss.
Right. Yeah, so I've got to be careful because I'm on planning, so I'm not going to tell you if things are wonderful or rubbish, because I want to go on down there. We checked when we got here. They might have been there the other week, I don't know. I can't remember if they were or not, but today, and when we started the meeting, me, Dave had a look, me and Amanda had a look, or Amanda, if you want to say it properly, we've had a look, we couldn't find it, so it wasn't there. But the first one, I've got some pictures here if anyone wants to have a look if it helps you. But the one thing I do want to say is, I can say this because I've already asked the council right of it. I've met with the bloke down there, but we didn't discuss this, and I told him, don't try and talk to me about this because I won't, because I'm on planning. But he's got a digger going down there, either, it might have even been, I don't know. He said within the next 2 weeks, and the dike that runs from the bottom of, is it obviously? North of the street, like this is there, he's clearing it all the way out around the corner, which is brilliant, because he said that's the only bit he owns, he's given me a map here, and he says the rest of it belongs to, I don't know if it does or not, so I can't argue, he said it's a mixture between Nottinghamshire County Council, he seems to think along the allotments is the town council, I'm not saying it is or not, because I don't know.
Yeah.
It's lots of different, that's the word, but he was concerned, when he clears his bit out, the stuff's still going to keep coming down, so I don't know how he got other people to do it, but he's definitely doing his bit, so I'm not chuffed with that. Boss, that's nothing to do with this, but I don't know if people want to look at these, I'll pass them around. As long as you're giving me back, because I'm doing it.
Just to point out, if you're going to discuss this, it's on Greenbelt. You know, Mark, there's no policy on Greenbelt. It's well known at the place.
I looked at these plans in great detail, and Councillor London is quite right, there is a problem on that. It's not the best of land, and looking at the map, except for the Greenbelt issue, I cannot see any problems with it at all. There's no really any objections at all.
They're not permanent structured lumping pods. It's like camping.
I just thought it flooded down there, because it's always like a wildfire, like a mud pond.
Just point it out.
Is that why he's doing the clearing it? Is that what you're doing?
Yes.
It's just, I don't think I'd like to watch it. Down to personal preference, I don't think I'd be wanting to. I'm going to stay for it. That's a
Mr. Mayor, I cannot see, as far as planning issues, there isn't one that you could really turn down. I can't see one, to be honest.
We're proposing on planning and not business. Proposal.
I suppose I should say that I do know Vic quite well, but I've never discussed this, and we don't. I'm just going to say hello to him.
You're very good to know personally.
Well, that's what I'm just saying, that I do know him to say hello to. That's about all.
You can't do a thing in your own person.
Yes, I can, because he's not an opportunity, none. and I declare that I know him to say hello to. The bit I would say is I have concerns about the green belt. I have concerns that it might end up eventually getting turned into proper housing, but as it's temporary things, I think under the planning thing, there probably isn't a problem. And it may improve some of the area around, which does sort of get rather dumped on, and the fact that there are people around might actually prevent some of the dumping. I do have concerns, and I share them with Council about the fact that this is on green belt, but I suspect that on the planning things, because they are not permanent structures, there wouldn't be an objection.
Councillor Darby?
Okay, well, I'd say not permanent structures, but the people have got to live in there, and they're going to have things insured. If it's a flood area, then they're not going to be able to insure it. Because it is known as a flood area.
Holidays.
Glamping as a posh.
Holidays
on this
day.
For those who wish to be surrounded in tents by savages, it's a 1 in 100 year event. They put in tiny little writing just to
pop up. Sorry,
I didn't know.
Does anybody know what the actual recreational use is?
Glamping bit. Sorry.
Because they're camping.
Camping.
Just camping.
Through the issue, I think you might find that that's not got that off to it. It's been off to the people to you.
Thank you.
Dave's clarified, he's the planning. Dave knows more about it than anybody's here. So, obviously, I don't have an issue with obviously, personal issue, I can't see it working, but there we are, let's stick to that. The planning thing, we surely then cannot.
There's
nothing on planning we can get it for, so.
Yeah, I would just say one thing, Councillor Darby here. We've already talked about people's insurance, it's got nothing to do with the foundation at all. Can we just take a vote on this?
That's not strictly true. If a person who buys a property down there and it floods and we haven't informed them, they can come back towards it. They could come back.
Because I think about glamping as well. So you just hire.
I know it's glamping, but the houses that's already down there, they get flooded quite regularly. And I've got a photograph when the water is up to the top of the
Sorry, can we just rate? I can understand where you're coming from. That was my concern, but as a point of. At the minute, we're just discussing this particular planning, and we can't see a problem with that particular.
There's nothing on planning you can comment on.
I know what you're coming from, but I think we need to move it on.
Let's make it a comment. About a year after Meadow View was built, we was down on the planning tour, and David Watson, who was chair of planning at the time, stated that's the place, that's the sort of thing that was not to be built. Did not happen. That's his own words. He pointed to the planning officers and the committee at the time.
And I suppose we take a vote on this rather than going round and round. I propose
that. So the proposal is.
Mr. Chair, just a point of clarification. You have to be ready. You want no objections or you wish to support it. I think you're just going with no objections, but that's what.
Yeah. So no objections.
All in favour, no objections.
Yeah. Right, those in favour of the objections, please raise your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Anyone against the proposal? Councillor Wayburn? Yes. Any objections?
They're drawn on that.
Those are drawn.
Thank you. Okay.
Next one is direction six, new industrial units and amended road layout on the former dye work site at West End Street and Station Street.
Mr. Chair, just a point of clarification for this, because the County Clerk won't know. This site has previously looked at for a similar proposal, and what they're doing is they're changing the road layout. It's not the actual units, it's the amendment of the road layout that's actually on the discussion.
I looked at these plans intensively, and I do not see a problem here at all. And I cannot see any objection at all. If people, and I know there are some who do not want it, it's up to them to contact the borough council themselves by this problem. But I'm quite happy with it.
Any other comments before we come back today?
I'm trying to read this on the thing. My concern, I haven't got any problem with the units. It's the amendment I'm trying to read. And I'm hoping it means what I say. But I can't read it.
I do apologise, as I want to say, there's no...
I can't read what that says. Because one of the things that I think is, I think it's very important, and it looks to me that that's doing, although I'm not quite sure which way. But I'm hoping that it says the flow should be over into that side, not out of it, on the bridge.
On the bridge,
Make it one way. That's what it says. Sorry, I can't read it.
Yes, it is.
It's in one way and out
the
other way. It's one way. I think I'm all right saying that. It's one way.
Yeah, it's just... So I can sort of say that's fine. That's the one bit I wanted to ensure that was there. Because I think it's great concern if anything had to turn out there. So in which case that's fine.
Councillor, I couldn't read it on the computer. Jason has just mentioned that, and I'm glad he did. But it is right.
Yeah.
So
can we close my
Mr. Chair.
Everyone needs to support this. The town needs the work. Yeah. It's not going to mind the access unless they have to get sorted. That's right. We desperately need as much work and industrial work as we can get. So let's go for it and grab it with both hands.
Anyone against for clarification for the minutes? Anyone abstaining?
That's it before we move on then.
Yeah, please. So I was going to say two things. I'm not sure if all the pictures are put back in the glamping things. It looks like I've got one missing, but I'm not sure.
Has anybody got one of Richard's
glamping things? I thought there was more than one colour one. I've only got one colour one here. It might be seeing things at that time.
That's fine. Chairman, again, it's a point of clarification for the minutes to Luke Clark. The next one, we don't have the plan to stay until we go to New
York.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Oh, sorry.
I was going to say to you, because I've said this to Margaret in the past, I'm saying the same thing to you. I'm on planning at Roxburgh, so if you ever want any maps, and I've always said this today, let me know, because I can go and get them printed out that big. Instead of that big, we use them for this. So let me know if you need anything to plan it. As long as you give me some notice, I can fetch one for you. It's not a problem.
Can I suggest that we write complaining that that is not on there? because it isn't the first time that Roxburgh have done this to us.
And
I think, whilst we can't discuss it, I think we should actually write to Roxburgh saying, we were unable to discuss this because you haven't stuck it on your website. And I think we should write and complain, because it's not the first time it's happened.
Chairman, again, there's a difference, don't minute this. I'm surviving that it's been withdrawn.
Next item then is appointment of responsible financial officer. Is this just voting?
Yes,
Chairman.
Colin,
you
can
have time in the toilet. All right. No, she's not very well. She's not very well checked. She's broken down.
Can you please,
ma'am? Sorry, just to reiterate. Appointment of responsible financial officer. Is that just to be noted or is it a discussion?
Okay, I have been appointed my start date is 4th of June.
Yeah.
And so I'm into my third week.
Yeah, well, responsible financial officer.
And I'm now responsible financial officer.
That means you have to give biscuits to everybody for next week.
You're on a diet.
Gaffer.
And then on to 16 risk assessments.
Can I just report that these are in place?
Now 17 is the annual government statement for 2017-18. So, acknowledging this document prior to commission to the external auditors.
Annual Governance Statement from 2017-18, Mr. Chair. If I would like to read these out. Item 1, we have put in place arrangements for effective financial management during the year and for the preparation of the accounting statements. We maintain an adequate system of internal control, including measures designed to prevent and detect fraud and corruption and reviewed its effectiveness. We took all reasonable steps to assure ourselves that there are no matters of actual or potential non-compliance with laws, regulations and proper practices that could have a significant financial effect on the ability of this authority to conduct its business or manage its finances. We provide proper opportunity during the year for the exercise of electors' rights in accordance with the requirements of the accounts and audit regulations. We carried out an assessment of the risks facing this authority and took appropriate steps to manage those risks, including the introduction of internal controls and or external insurance cover where required. We maintained throughout the year an adequate and effective system of internal audit of the accounting records and control systems. We took appropriate action on all matters raised in reports from internal and external audit. We considered whether any litigation, liabilities or commitments, events or transactions occurring either during or after the year end have a financial impact on this authority and, where appropriate, have included them in the accounting statements. Trust funds, including charitable, in our capacity as a sole managing trustee, we discharge our accountability responsibilities for the fund assets, including financial reporting and, if required, independent examination or audit, and this is not applicable. That's the annual government statement. Can you note it, please? Okay.
And we've got 18, which is the accounting statement. This is the acknowledgement of the Board of Qualifications document is prior to submission to the external auditors as well.
This has been completed and has been submitted to the...
It has been checked by the accountants and the internal... Excuse me, for clarification, Mr. Manager. This document, All figures have been checked by the accountant and the internal auditor and will now, after looking at the town council, be submitted to the external auditor.
Okay.
Thank you. Can we do that, please?
Thank you.
Right, and payments.
Just very quickly, that's the payments for this one.
I know that we all supposed to listen to every councillor and the town clerk and the leader of the council and yourself. But if we could have these sheets, as I've already said in previous meetings, at the beginning of the meeting, it would be helpful just to go through them, because with respect to Dan Dart and Margaret, I ain't got time to go through this now before you ring the bell for finishing.
Mr. Chairman, I apologise, I brought them in with me, but because I don't usually hand them out, it will clean out their mind.
Can we make a motion to that councillors get it before the meeting?
I do apologise.
Either on the evening, if the leader of the council were happy with it. We're not complaining about the new town clerk at all.
No, I understand what you're saying, but that in earlier
Once we're in, can we have a here later, so we can at least look at them before we
Thank you very much.
Margaret will have to answer this, but we have down there still locality funding and a neighbourhood plan. What's happening? Because undoubtedly we've got to pay what we're paying for that.
As the chairman, we need to pay the money back and then reapply. I keep phoning them to find out the process for this, and they keep phoning back and leaving me a number, and when I phone the number, no one answers, and there's no answer phone. I am chasing them.
That's a plan,
Until I can speak to I phoned the general number and I've got switchboard, who put me through to a number that's rang out as well. I'm doing my best to contact these people.
That's what we need to do.
I want rid of it as well.
And so all the members are aware that is not our money on the offer.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Mr. Chairman, quick clarification. Because it's a 6-weekly meeting period, usually what we send out is the end.
The first one, because that's a real indication of what the situation is.
Mr. Chairman, we only saw this document this afternoon ourselves.
We have it as the 27th of July at 7 p.m. as usual.
Please bring any late birthday presents on that day, thank you.
Remind everybody of Bobby from on the please put in your diary. It's at St. Helens Church.
Just before we conclude, of course, is we know Margaret will be finishing on the 29th of June. So, just from the town council, Paul Farnley, wish you well.
Thank you.
All those
ladies. In saying that, I won't be back to run the copy prom because I said I would do it for nothing. So, I'll be back on the 8th of September to see how you all are. Please come, it's a brilliant event.
Can I make a suggestion? I think Margaret likes the Melrose, because she'd like to take it with her, because we haven't really had to use it tonight.
I've got my own. Thank you very much.
Yeah.